Hey everybody, it's Jason Blaha here, and sitting here drinking my morning coffee. Getting ready to get my day started, get some squats going, because you guys know I squat every day. Some people linked to me, actually several people linked to me, and I went and watched it. And it was a live stream, so it's kind of hard to follow because it stopped a lot. I had to watch it in several segments just because of the fact that YouTube with their live streaming is not always that good. But Mike Dolce actually made what I consider to be a pretty respectful commentary of my DEXA scan, everything else, and answering some questions from people who said, is Jason Blaha morbidly obese? And you know what? I actually am going to discuss this because I appreciate the fact that the guy was actually respectful in his criticisms. He was respectful in the fact of saying, hey, you know, the guy's got balls for even putting his DEXA scan up because, you know, he knows guys who are in better shape who would be terrified to do that publicly. And he was very, very objective. He was objective in his criticism. It didn't come across as mean-spirited, hateful, trolling, anything like that. So I'm going to actually discuss it. And you know what? I'm going to go out on a limb and say, actually, I think his criticism was fair. And I agree with a lot of what he said there. And it's stuff that I've realized on my own. So that's something I want to make clear. But what I thought was interesting is that even a few of my trolls and haters showed up there, and they asked things, and his point was, when people said, oh, I think Jason's insane or whatever else, he pointed out that, you know what, he works with a lot of elite-level athletes, he works with professionals, and he's like, people's personas, because he's worked with everyone from, you know, Ronda Rousey to Conor McGregor, he knows all these people, and he's like, the personas that people put out in public in the entertainment businesses, and that includes YouTube, may not be who they really are like. Meaning the way they come across or the image is projected is not always indicative of who they are. So without knowing me, he's like, I can't tell you anything about the guy personally. I actually appreciate that because there's a lot of truth to that. I'm sure a lot of what I do is historically has just been, the way I am on as far as it's a persona I put out. Now, in the last year or so, I've brought that in and I try to just be myself more, which I think is different. It's actually been me actually just being myself and just acting the way and talking the way I normally talk around people that I know personally, just kind of being myself. Actually seems to be working better. My channel has grown more doing that. But back to the point. He pointed out, having a look at the DEXA scan, that, you know, he's like, yeah, Jason is obese on these charts based upon BMI and body fat. He's not necessarily morbidly obese, and that was a good point. But it's a point I'm going to agree with. I wouldn't be considered morbidly obese yet because I've had blood work done. I've had my vitals done. My blood pressure is in the normal range, totally normal range. Fasting glucose and everything are okay. I'm not experiencing signs of insulin insensitivity. I don't have high blood pressure. So for now, irrespective of the fact that I'm 23.7% body fat, or I was a few days ago, my scale's been coming down. I'm down another half pound since that. But again, I started losing weight right before the DEXA scan. And that's kind of a take home, and it needs to be brought home here, is that he said, you know, at his age, my age being anything 25% plus is an enormous, enormous risk factor. I'm sure I was over 25% a month ago, but I've dropped like 10 pounds. I've dropped 10 pounds already before I did the DEXA scan. So when people say, oh, you losing any, because I saw someone in the comments I mentioned yesterday, I was down a half pound in my training clips, and people are like, oh, that's just water loss. It's like, I already have started cutting. It's like, this isn't like a sudden thing. It's like the scale has been coming down every single week. It's been coming down every week. But I'll agree with him. And he said, you know what, the fact that I've said that I want to get to 15% body fat is that he's like, I can't hate on that. If a guy's carrying what he considers to be an unhealthy amount of body fat, and you know what, I agree. I'm not going to mince words about it. Yeah, I did gain some extra weight again trying to rebuild a strength base. But I've reached a point with my training where I know I can lose weight. I know I can lose body fat and I can continue to gain strength. Because realistically speaking, I don't want to just gain 10 more pounds on my squat. I need to gain 100 pounds on my squat, right? I need to gain 100 pounds on my squat. I need to put 60 pounds on my bench press. But I feel like my training and my lifestyle are on point enough that I can start moving towards those goals while losing body fat, right? And of course, he said he wants to see for his athletes, The 12 to 14% body fat range is the sweet spot. You know, we'll see what I can do long term, guys. We need to be short term, at least to some extent, in our goals. You've got to break goals off in bite-sized chunks. Right now, my goal is just to, by the end of the year, to get to 15% body fat, put another 50, 60 pounds on my squat while getting to 15% body fat. Okay, that's a more realistic goal for me. That's a realistic goal. But I do appreciate the fact that he pointed out a number of things. You know, he's really big on Whole Foods. I don't know a lot about Mike. I do know who he is. Obviously, if you're in this game, you know who he is. And it's funny because he said, you know, I mean, he has a pretty small YouTube channel compared to mine, so I might not watch it. If you were a nobody who had 30,000 subscribers, he was just talking smack, no, I wouldn't watch it. People are always like, this person, that person. I don't care. I don't watch those. I legitimately don't watch those. But when I see Mike Dolce, someone who does have a reputation for working with elite athletes, for being a dietitian for elite athletes, it doesn't mean I necessarily know everything about what he does or agree with everything that he does. But the fact of the matter is, this is someone with some bona fides, right? This is someone with some bona fides. When he's going to have some criticism or discuss something I'm doing, I'm going to chime in and listen. It doesn't matter that his YouTube isn't that big. The fact is, he has other outreach outside of YouTube. And if he's going to give some criticism or some feedback, that's not something I'm going to sit around and take personally or take a smack talking. I'm going to jump in and say, okay, let's see what this guy has to say. Maybe I should pay attention. Maybe I should pay attention. And the thing was, I found myself agreeing with him. And let's be realistic here. I hope it didn't come across too much that I think that I'm sitting at some really healthy body fat when I did the DEXA scan. I did the DEXA scan for a couple of reasons. You guys remember last time I did a 30-pound cut when I weighed myself in on camera a couple times? I did videos of my weigh-ins. You guys notice I actually did drop 30 pounds. Why? Because I was now all of a sudden accountable. I was accountable. Because then other people are going to expect me to do other weigh-ins. I all of a sudden become accountable to everyone watching at that point. And it comes down to this point of what we call investments also. Investments. Anytime you invest money or resources or time into something, what do we tend to do? We tend to be more successful with it. That's a reality. That's like a trap that people get caught in. It's an investment trap that lets people get scammed easily. But I spent $90 on a DEXA scan. I signed up to get more DEXA scans. I've already said I'm going to have to publish my DEXA scans. So I've already spent money out of my own pocket to measure this, right? Now, because I've actually spent, and I know $90 isn't that much money, but I spent $90 out of my own pocket. Got all this interesting data. And it was more interesting beyond the body fat. Well, now I've got this data and I've published it. I've obligated myself to another DEXA scan in 3 months. I'm going to have to spend money on that DEXA scan also. And I'm looking at it going, man, if I don't see an improvement on this DEXA scan, if it doesn't improve, I just threw money away. I just wiped my ass with another $90. I don't want to do that. I'm cheap with my money, guys. I am cheap with my money. I'm a penny pincher. I spreadsheet every penny I spend. Like, Brittany laughs at me. You guys see all the hand loading and other stuff I do. I actually spreadsheet my primers and gunpowder so that I know exactly for any given amount of ammo or something I make, how many pennies I spend making 1,000 rounds. Yeah, I'm that cheap. So when I look at it in that perspective, like, man, I'm spending money on this. I'm invested. And I've got accountability. And I did it for other reasons. What I also wanted to do was look at the Bulgarian style training, which I'm a big fan of. I have been for many years. I've been waiting to where I could get to a place in my life to do it again, which I started doing again. I don't know anyone out there who's in their 40s who is doing this style of training and really documenting it. So for me, that DEXA scan lets me have the ability to look at this training and go, okay, how much can a guy my age, if I put X amount of weight on my squat, X amount of weight on my bench press, X amount of weight on my weighted chin-ups, these exercises, how much does it correspond in lean body mass gain? Also, we can track the changes in body composition, changes in bone density. I can look at, since it breaks down my legs, I even know how much muscle I have in each leg. It will let me know how much weight on the bar on the squat for me, or someone with my structure is going to correspond with 50 pounds on a squat, right? It's a really, really valuable tool that I'm going to be able to use to document this training system. So, I mean, I'm killing a couple of birds with one stone, and the body fat thing is a side effect. But let's be realistic here. Let's go back to the point. I'm not a spring chicken anymore. We're watching these YouTubers drop dead. I have a history of heart disease in my family. And as much as I want to gain strength, as much as I would love to just dream or bulk and get super strong, and I do plan on getting super strong, heart disease runs in my family. Is like, see, on both sides. I can't be walking around at 25% body fat, 24% body fat in my 40s. Mike is absolutely right. That shit will kill me. That shit will kill me. Might not be next year, might not be for 5 years, but I can't keep that up. I can't do that. I have a vested interest in staying alive. A vested interest in staying alive and staying healthy, staying fit. Yes, I want to be a strength athlete. Yes, I want to go do strength sports, even in the masters. But I've got to watch my health. I've got to pay attention to that. I mean, yes, this is a strength conditioning channel, but it's also a fitness channel. And even though I'm not experiencing high blood pressure right now, even though, you know, even when I was heavier, my blood pressure came back normal. Last time I had a doctor checkup, just a couple months ago, blood pressure was normal. Fasting blood glucose was normal. Is that going to stay that way forever? What happens if I stay at 25% body fat for the next 5 years? Blood pressure is probably going to go up. Probably going to start developing insulin resistance. All right, this is a problem. And at this point, I've made myself accountable. I've invested money in measuring my body fat with the most accurate tool that I have available to me. I've published it publicly. It's going to be useful for a lot of other stuff that I want to be able to research, stuff that I want to be able to have my own personal anecdote to document, to show for a training style I would like to see become more popular. So it gives me a lot of options there, but the fact of the matter is I've now made myself accountable to the public. I've made myself accountable to myself. I've made myself accountable to my pocketbook. So for me, that's my way to motivate myself, just a tool in the toolbox to motivate myself to get better results, to work on my overall fitness more, right? And that's what it's all about. And I really appreciate the fact that Mike was able to sit back and as a health professional give objective criticism without being insulting, without worrying about anything but looking at the facts. And I actually respect the fact that he did that. I respect the fact that he did that. And that just is what it is. All right, guys, but that's really all I have to say on that today. I hope it's been informative, and I will talk to you guys next time.